English language conventions. Inappropriate, verb tense. ACT Foundation, question 45. Me, medicine, antidote your ignorance. ACT English Foundation, verb tense, question 45. Fix any verb that doesn't match the tense of the verb in bold. The waiter poured a glass of ice water while the customer reads and thinks about the menu. Here's what I need you to understand. The tense of a verb tells you when the action takes place. Do not shift tenses within or between sentences unless you need to reflect a time change. Let's take a look at this example. Rachel grabbed the microphone and speaks to the crowd. The featured verb grabbed is written in the simple past verb tense. So we know the speaking also took place in the past. However, the verb speak is written in the simple present tense. There is no need to reflect the time change. Both verbs should be in the same tense. Shifting the tense of the second verb to its present tense form is incorrect because it creates inconsistency in the overall tense of the sentence. Change speaks to its simple past tense form to restore consistency. So there you have it. We've changed speaks to spoke, and this is correct. All right, back to the original question, and now for the solution. Look at the bold verb poured. It is written in the simple past tense. So we know the rest of the events also take place in the past. However, the second verb reads and the third verb thinks are written in the simple, singular, third person, present tense verb form. There is no need to reflect a time change. All the verbs should be in the same tense. Shifting the tense of the second and third verbs to their present tense forms is incorrect, because this creates inconsistency in the overall tense of the sentence. Change reads and thinks to their simple past tense forms to restore consistency. Here you have it. We've changed reads to read and thinks to thought. They're simple, singular, third person past tense verb forms. We have restored consistency and these are correct. I also want you to notice that many regular third person singular present tense verbs and regular plural nouns have opposite rules of formation as it relates to pluralization. Regular, third-person, singular, present tense verbs take an S at the end, as in reads and thinks, whose singular subject is the customer, whereas regular plural nouns take an S at the end. I don't see any regular plural nouns in this example sentence, so let's use my favorite example, cookies. Here we have multiple cookies. Hence, this noun ends in an S, thus demonstrating the opposite rules of formation as it relates to the pluralization of regular, third-person, singular, present tense verbs versus regular plural nouns.